The Great Barrier Reef is the hottest it's been for 400 years.
400 years.
400 years.
400 years.
400 years.
400 years.
400 years. Or so they say.
Water temperature extremes around the Great Barrier Reef are the warmest for 400 years. Over the last decade, it's resulted in more mass bleaching events of the coral. Scientists in Australia who have examined the skeletons of coral and historic data say the evidence is clear that the reef is in danger and governments have to act now against climate change.
The scientists examined long coral cores, samples drilled out of the bodies of centuries-old coral. These contain chemical clues that reveal how warm the water was during the life of the reef. Combining this with historical sea temperature records showed that in just the last decade, temperatures around the Great Barrier Reef were the warmest of the past 400 years.
So you've seen those headlines, it's a disaster, 400 years of ending up being cooked. And this data has been taken from the strontium calcium ratios of corals. You drill a hole in corals, you measure the strontium calcium ratios, and as the coral gets bigger and bigger over time, you can actually work out the temperature at the time it was growing. And this is the graph that has been shown around the world. And indeed, according to this, the coral sea is actually hotter now than it has been for the last 400 years. But notice it's for the coral sea and not the Great Barrier Reef. So here's a map of the sites that they used. Now, we'll come back to that temperature graph for the coral sea in a second, but there is a second graph that doesn't seem to have been publicised, and this is actually the graph for the Great Barrier Reef, not the coral sea. And in this second graph, you can actually see that the actual Great Barrier Reef is at the same temperature now that it was in the 1700s. So, nothing particular to worry about at all. Now, believe me, this proxy temperature data using calcium strontium ratios, it needs to have a full audit. There's all sorts of problems that can come in. It may well be very, very solid, but it does need an audit. And of course, one has to be a little bit extra cautious about it, given the fact that all the publicity from the scientists itself has been focusing on the coral sea, and then they talk about the Great Barrier Reef. Why did they do that? But more importantly, for the graph for the Great Barrier Reef, why did the temperature fall between the 1700s and 1800s and then start to rise again? The narrative we've got at the moment is, in fact, the temperature was rock solid for about 1,000 years until it started to rise in, say, the 1850s. Well, the Great Barrier Reef didn't do that, and the Great Barrier Reef is now at the same temperature that it was when Captain Cook sailed up this coast. But let's go back to the coral sea graph, which does show a peak over the last 400 years. Now, again, this needs auditing for one reason. Why is the coral sea, which is right next to the Great Barrier Reef, why is the temperature so very different? It doesn't show this peak in the 1700s and the fall from 1700s to the 1800s. But also, why is there a rise in temperature from, say, the 1600s to the 1800s. Half the total rise in the last 400 years is before the Industrial Revolution even started, say, in the 1800s. Look, my main concern with this whole paper, which, by the way, I think has got some very fascinating data, is the slickness of the publicity, even by some of the scientists themselves. For example, why didn't they mention the Great Barrier Reef curve showing it was the same as the 1700s? And why didn't they mention that despite the 4 or 5 catastrophic supposedly bleaching events in the last few years, which was in all this publicity, why didn't they just mention that, well, actually the Great Barrier Reef has got more coral now than it had before all these catastrophic bleaching events and has now got record amounts of coral? It makes you wonder what's going on here, doesn't it?